Hi everyone, it's Morgan. I know, things are different, right? Like I'm a lot older and I'm not a child anymore.
Weird.
It's been 5 years since I posted my last video, so let's talk about that. If you hear anything in the background, it is my dog. I'm gonna try to get him. Oh, here he is. This is Mav. He is my Doberman, he's 3. And he's a really good boy and he's my best bud. So yeah, clearly a lot happened since the last time you saw me. So I'm gonna catch you up super fast. I'm not gonna dwell on this because we have lots of exciting things to talk about. Basically, when I posted my last video, I was a senior in high school, I think, or maybe a junior, I think senior. So I was getting ready to head off to college. I had Willie and Sadie at the time. We ended up rehoming them to a girl that I actually worked with. The girl that I rehomed them to, she had a special needs son who really loved bunnies, and we ended up rehoming them to him. So they lived a very nice, happy life with their family. And of course, it made me really, really sad, but I knew that they were going to a good place. And now it has been many years since I've had a rabbit, and I'm really looking forward to hopefully getting another one really soon. So just to give you kind of a breakdown, I now live in Florida. I have my own apartment. I'm 23 and I live by myself with my Doberman Maverick that you just saw sticking his giant head in here. While I was gone, I went to Clemson University. I majored in pre-veterinary medicine. I ended up actually getting my degree in psychology. It's a very long story. Essentially, I had a double major and my emphasis in pre-vet was nutrition. Also, I'm really sorry about the lighting. I promise every other video from here on out is going to be good. I have a good camera and a mic and everything now. What I learned over the course of going to school, being a nurse, and kind of just life experience, being around rabbits in a general sense, is that I was doing everything wrong. And you know what? That's okay, because there's not a lot of information out there and you really have a hard time finding it unless you're looking for it. What I learned is that as a 15, 16 year old girl, when I started this channel, I didn't know everything. I wasn't the worst, but I wasn't the best. I'm not the best now. We're all learning every day and just continuing to gain our knowledge and get better and just improve as much as we possibly can. So today I'm actually going to be reacting to one of my more popular videos that I called Bunny Basics Before Getting a Rabbit. Okay, sorry for the change of lighting. It got really dark, so.
I'm going to be teaching you how to properly set up your rabbit's cage.
So, oh, the camera migrated, I'm so sorry. So first thing, right off the bat, the flooring that I was using in here was actually a foam board with sticky laminate tiles. If you use something malleable as your base, your rabbit's probably gonna chew it up. I think the best thing to use is something that is safe for your rabbit to chew on if it does happen, or something that they can't chew on. So I think in a future build, my dad actually made me a custom cage. The bottom was made out of wood and we actually wrapped a laminate sheet around it, and that worked perfectly. The rabbits didn't have any edges that they could get to. This cage, they ended up actually chewing on the laminate and the foam, and they were actually ingesting it, which is really bad. Well, I don't recommend actually following the advice that I gave in my how to build a bunny condo, because the flooring that I used was not safe. So let's continue.
So what I've gone ahead and done now is just laid the fleece down laminate tiles. And now I'm just going to show you everything that needs to go inside the cage. First, you're going to need a litter box, a bowl, preferably one that's heavy.
Okay, let's talk about the litter box. I'm going to do a whole video on litter boxes, so this is going to be short and sweet. The litter box I was using was okay for Willie, and at his age, I think he was only like 9 weeks old. He was really tiny, so that was fine at the time. Typically, I would just suggest that you go ahead and get a cat litter box. The litter box that I'm showing here, those corner litter boxes, the ones made for small pets, made for rabbits, not actually made for rabbits, not actually that great. But I do not recommend.
So it can't be tipped over. A water bottle.
Again, a water bottle, you know, I think this is a somewhat controversial topic, but I do not think water bottles are great. First of all, your rabbit can't get enough water. Your rabbit needs constant access to as much water as they need.
The water bottles can be very frustrating. They only get a few drops at a time as they're lapping and lapping and lapping. They're getting more thirsty, and they're also swallowing air bubbles, which is not good for their GI tract. It's just not ideal, so I don't recommend. I just recommend getting a heavy ceramic bowl or a non-tip bowl.
A hay rack or a hay tube.
Again, oh my god, this is gonna happen the whole time. Do not suggest just doing one of these. If you're gonna do a hay tube like I have here, you wanna get like three or four. This is just simply not enough hay. The spaces were big enough for Willie to grab out of it at his age. It was fine, but just simply not enough access.
Somewhere for him to hide, like a tunnel, igloo, or a hidey house of some kind. And lots of things for your bunny to chew on. And of course, you're gonna need litter, food, and hay. So these are the things that I use every day for my bunny. So first, this is kind of weird, but I have like a wad of paper towels because he's free range in my room whenever I can supervise him.
Yeah, so I was using Fresh World. I haven't done a ton of research on where they're at now, but I think that litter was fine, paper-based litter. I think typically the best suggestion is normally gonna be like Carefresh. I ended up moving to wood pellets because it's a lot cheaper and that worked for me. Probably when I get my new rabbit in January, I'm gonna stick to Carefresh because I didn't like how messy the wood pellets were because they turn into sawdust once they're actually peed on. So it's really hard to clean the litter box and it gets really nasty. Of course, litter boxes are nasty anyway, but I have an apartment, so I'm gonna have my rabbit living in the apartment and I need things that are kind of easier to clean because I won't have access to like a garden hose and things like that. So
I recommend using this because any litter that's cedar or pine can be really harmful to your rabbit. Like the bits can get into their eyes, it can cause skin problems and all sorts of things.
That stuff was true. I actually knew something. Rabbits have really, really sensitive upper respiratory tracts, and little, you know, particles and dust can get really backed up in there. They can cause tons of issues. They're even more sensitive than cats, so I definitely suggest something that's not super, super dusty. Things like wood shavings are just not good. Straw, not my favorite. So if you're going to use a bedding, I would definitely suggest one of the ones that I mentioned earlier. I don't know what brand this was. It looks pretty dusty, and I don't suggest getting them in these little bags. It's really not enough hay. I don't know why you would waste your money getting such a small bag.
Available to them. This helps with their digestion, and it helps kind of just even everything out. So I really recommend giving them alfalfa hay. They should never be fed iceberg lettuce and carrots, apples, bananas, things like that. Those are all treats.
Okay, so I had a good point there. I got a little bit off topic with the hay, but hay is for fiber. It keeps their GI tracts running and it keeps the muscles strong so that they can continue to push food through. As many of you know, rabbits' digestive systems are constantly moving, and if they're not, they can go into something called GI stasis. Very dangerous. It can kill your rabbit in under 12 hours, and they need fiber to strengthen those intestinal muscles. And if they're not eating their hay, or if they're not eating enough hay, they are in serious danger and they can die really fast.
So just look it up if you're not sure what kind of food they can eat, because some foods can be very harmful to rabbits. House Rabbit Society is a really good website to look at. They have lots of information about what kind of food you should feed your rabbit and all sorts of things like that. So just make sure that you do lots of research before you get a rabbit.
And again, I will be doing a updated video on rabbit diet. I do have a video on my channel. I'm trying to decide if I'm gonna end up unlisting some of these videos because the information isn't very accurate, so I don't know if I want them floating around, but.
So the next things I have are brushes. This I actually got at PetSmart. It's a guinea pig brush because they didn't have rabbit brushes there. I'm sure they carry them in some stores, but they didn't have them at mine. So this is a guinea pig brush. It doesn't work all that well.
I had a good point there. Of course it's not gonna work well. Rabbits have really fine hair. Small Pet Select has a good brush, and I can't remember the name of it right now. I'll put a picture right there. That's the one that I suggest. That's one that I have on my rabbit list right now for things that I'm gonna pick up for my rabbit before I get him or her. So that's what I suggest, is like cat brushes, dog brushes, guinea pig brushes, or small pet brushes are not gonna cut it.
Like crazy chemicals or anything, it's just.
I think my vet had given me this because Willie got some kind of particle in his eye and it really scared me. I thought he had conjunctivitis, but he didn't. So they just directed us to do an eye rinse. And I think it's good to have this on hand because their eyes are really sensitive and it's easy for them to get things stuck in their eyes. So I think having just a very plain saline eye wash on hand is definitely a good idea.
The most frequently used item.
Yes, I hold to that. I'm going to get another one before I get my rabbit. I definitely recommend. You need one. You do. And probably a shop vac too.
That I have for my bunny is this little handheld broom and dustpan. I use this to do little clean sweeps. He tends to kick like messes outside of his cage, so I just like to sweep that up. And then also, if he uses the bathroom outside of his litter box, I just go in, sweep it up, and put it inside of his litter box.
Okay, so I was having some trouble getting the rest of the video to play, but I think that was actually a majority of what I went through. I feel like currently my opinions don't really completely line up with those things. So it actually wasn't as bad as I remembered it being, but you know, I was young and I didn't have all the information. I have a lot more information now. This is just kind of a note for everyone that we're not doing everything right. No one knows the perfect thing, and sometimes what you need to do for your rabbit is going to be up to your situation. You just do the best that you can with the information that you have. So I think if you're on YouTube and you're searching around for answers and you're trying to get the right information, that's like the best thing that you can be doing. We're in a social climate right now where people take certain opinions as scripture and people can be really harsh. I don't want this channel to be a place for that. I want it to be a place where we can all learn together. Thank you so much for watching me react to my very silly, childish videos. I'm really excited about the future of this channel. So the fun part's kind of over, but I am going to go through a little bit of like my plans for this channel. I have tons, literally a whole note on my phone full of ideas, like just completely full of ideas. So, in future videos coming up really soon, I'm going to be going over my supply list. I actually have updated my blog, and the link to my blog is going to be in the description of this video. So, please go ahead and check it out. My full supply list is on there with links to everything. I'm gonna try to add blogs weekly, especially as I'm searching for a rabbit. And I will have a video out going over my supply list and kind of what you need and the general startup costs before getting a rabbit. As far as where I'm at with finding a rabbit, right now it is tomorrow's Thanksgiving. And I am going to be traveling a lot. So this weekend I'm going back to Florida, and then I'll be coming back to South Carolina to be with my family for Christmas. And then I'm going to New Orleans for New Year's. So I have a lot of traveling going on the next couple of months. And I definitely don't want to put a rabbit through the stress of being brought to a new place and then their owner leaving and like new people taking care of them. It's very stressful. So I'm gonna wait until somewhere around the first or second week of January to bring my rabbit home. So I have been in talks with a rescue. I have a very specific rabbit that I really, really want to bring home, but he is at the rescue now and he could get adopted at any point. I actually talked to the lady at the rescue and she did say that he actually has a fungal ear infection right now. And so we're going to see if he'll be getting better right around the same time that I am trying to get my rabbit, which will hopefully be in January, but that's kind of a long time. It's about a month. I'm not sure if he'll be available. I have also put myself on a waiting list for a Holland Lop breeder. I can't find mini lops anywhere, and I really wanted to get another mini lop. Willie was a mini lop, and Sadie was a Holland Lop, and I just really had a special connection with Willie, but I think that had more to do with his personality. So I am on a waiting list with a breeder. She's a reputable breeder. The only way that I suggest actually purchasing a rabbit, and she was really difficult to find, and I did have to go on a waiting list, and I'll probably be on it right up until I'm ready to bring a rabbit home, and I may even have to wait longer if I do go that route. So if the bunny that I want to adopt from the rescue has been adopted at that time, then I probably will go with the breeder, but I am trying to lean toward the adoption route. So that's just kind of where I am at with this right now. I will be doing vlogs and everything to update you guys. Please make sure that you're checking up on my blog, follow me on Instagram. And I do post on my blog, I'll be posting about the blog update on my Instagram account, so make sure that you're following me there so that you can be updated when I update my blog. So thank you guys so much for watching, and if you're here from 5 years ago, welcome back. I'm so excited to jump back into this community, and if you're new, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you guys will subscribe and stick around. I'll see you soon. Bye.